Did you know that just like skin color, the way our skin feels, its texture, is also a story of human evolution? When you shake someone's hand or brush against their arm, you might notice that some skin feels silky and smooth, while other skin feels firm, velvety, or even rugged. These differences are subtle, but they are real, and they tell us something extraordinary about how humans adapted to the climates of the world. Our skin is not just a cover. It is a living record of ancestry, survival, and environment. Across humanity, it stretches from the thick, silky shields of West Africans to the papery wrinkles of the Khoisan in Southern Africa, from the smooth resilience of East Asians to the velvety softness of Polynesians. Each texture carries a legacy. Just as melanin tells the story of sun exposure, skin texture tells the story of heat, dryness, humidity, and even wind. It is an evolutionary map written in collagen and oil. To understand this, we have to go back to our ancestors. As humans spread out of Africa tens of thousands of years ago, they entered every kind of environment: humid forests, dry deserts, snowy plains, and salty coasts. Skin had to adapt not only in color, but also in structure. Melanin protected against ultraviolet rays. But texture was about balance: how much moisture the skin could hold, how flexible it was, how long it could resist wrinkles and sagging under the sun. The science behind this lies in collagen, the protein fibers that form the skin's scaffolding. Some populations have denser collagen, which makes the skin feel firm and wrinkle slowly. Others have looser collagen, which makes skin feel soft but age earlier. Oil glands also matter. More oil means a natural moisturizer and smoothness. Less oil means dryness and a matte surface. These small differences, repeated over generations, created the textures we feel today. Extremely thick skin. Some skin types are built like nature's strongest armor. Extremely thick skin is smooth, firm, and silky, almost as if a layer of moisturizer has been applied beneath the surface. Its strength comes from dense collagen fibers and natural oils that give it both resilience and a gentle sheen. Because of this combination, wrinkles appear very late, sometimes decades after they would in Europeans. Even into old age, this skin type holds its shape, resisting sagging and keeping a youthful look. In hot, humid tropical climates, this makes perfect sense. Strong sun and heavy moisture can easily damage or dehydrate the body, but extremely thick skin locks in water while blocking ultraviolet rays. It is one of the most durable human adaptations to heat and humidity. You find this texture most famously in West Africa, among groups like the Yoruba of Nigeria or the Akan of Ghana and Côte d'Ivoire. It also shows up in rainforest Bantu peoples of the Congo Basin, whose smooth and supple skin developed under the constant humidity of dense forests. Beyond Africa, parts of South Asia also carry this pattern. In southern India and Sri Lanka, people such as Tamils, Telugus, and Sinhalese often have thicker, slightly oily skin that stays firm and youthful under tropical heat and monsoon sun. Thick skin. Thick skin shares the firmness of the previous type, but without the same silky oils. It is strong and resilient, but it has a drier, more matte quality. Over time, it often takes on a rugged look, as if the climate itself has carved lines into it. This kind of skin is especially adapted to semi-arid and savanna environments where sun is fierce and water is scarce. It works like a natural fortress against dryness and is excellent at slowing down aging, though it may become leathery with decades of exposure. In places with open skies and little shade, thick skin is one of humanity's best protections against both heat and wind. This type appears across the Sahel in peoples such as the Sudanids of Senegal, Mali, Niger, and Chad. In East Africa, it belongs to Nilotic peoples like the Dinka, Nuer, and Shilluk, whose tall, lean bodies and dry, tensile skin show adaptation to harsh savanna life. It is also common among savanna Bantu groups such as the Zulu, Shona, and Kikuyu. Outside Africa, Aboriginal Australians, Papuans, and Melanesians also show this pattern, with skin that resists wrinkling but often becomes leathery after decades under some of the strongest ultraviolet rays on Earth. Soft skin. Soft skin is smooth, velvety, and elastic, often with a gentle oiliness that keeps it supple. It holds moisture well, making it perfect for forests, coasts, and humid lowlands. Because of its flexibility, wrinkles are slow to appear, and even when they do, they are often shallow. This kind of skin ages gracefully, staying fresh and youthful for many decades. It is also one of the most varied types, showing up in different parts of the world, but always tied to regions with water, humidity, or balanced climates. In Central Africa, this type belongs to the rainforest pygmies, such as the Mbuti, Aka, and Baka, whose cushion-like skin reflects the shaded humidity of the equatorial forest. Across Southeast Asia, peoples of Thailand, Cambodia, and the Philippines share this softness, as do Polynesians like Samoans, Tongans, and Maori, whose skin remains fresh despite salt air and tropical sun. In East Asia, the Chinese, Japanese, Koreans, and Mongols display a firmer version of soft skin, dense with collagen and wrinkle-resistant, showing age more in pigmentation than in lines. This trait traveled with their ancestors across the Pacific, where it remains among Native Americans. Around the Mediterranean and West Asia, people like Italians, Egyptians, Pashtuns, and Punjabis show balanced softness, while Arabs and Tuareg Berbers have smooth yet slightly weathered skin, molded by desert winds and sun. In Europe's mountain regions, from Armenia to Bosnia to Switzerland, the same elasticity helps skin adapt to both cold winters and strong summer sunlight. Extremely soft skin. At the most delicate end of the spectrum is extremely soft skin. This type is fine, thin, and almost papery to the touch. Unlike thicker skins, it wrinkles early, sometimes as young as 30, and with age, it folds into loose curtains around the face. While it may seem fragile, this adaptation was useful in extreme climates. Thin, flexible skin is better at handling rapid changes, whether in desert heat that shifts to freezing nights or in cold northern regions with long winters. Its beauty is in its sensitivity, though it often comes with quicker visible aging. This skin is most famously seen among the Khoisan peoples of Southern Africa, whose unique adaptation fits the arid deserts of the Kalahari. A similar pattern occurs in Northern Europeans, Nordics and Slavs, where soft, dry skin reflects centuries of cold winters rather than hot deserts. The Himalayan highlands of Nepal and Bhutan also show this type, shaped by cold, dry mountain winds. Cushitic groups like the Somalis, Afar, and Oromo, as well as Ethiosamites such as the Amhara, Tigray, and Harari, belong here too, though their wrinkling follows a different path. Instead of folding early like the Khoisan or Nordics, their extremely soft skin develops fine lines slowly, aging with a gentler surface pattern. In South Asia, Bengalis also show this soft delicacy, while in the Americas, Andean Highlanders and Amazon natives share it, though their skin tends to crease gradually rather than fold. These differences show how even within one broad type, the exact pattern of aging shifts depending on climate and ancestry. When we step back, a pattern begins to emerge. Tropical forests favor silky, moist, velvety skin. Savannas and deserts shape firm, dry, rugged skin. Cold climates bring soft but wrinkle-prone skin. And temperate zones? They give us delicate textures that vary with ancestry. Skin texture is not random. It is nature's experiment in survival. But texture is more than biology. It is also culture. In Africa, silky, youthful skin is praised as a sign of vitality. In East Asia, smooth and firm skin stands as the highest standard of beauty. In Europe, pale and soft skin has long symbolized refinement, even as wrinkle anxiety followed with age. Wherever you look, skin is both an adaptation and an identity. So the next time you meet someone, remember this. Beneath what feels silky, firm, velvety, or delicate lies a story written by climate, ancestry, and time. Skin texture is more than touch. It is human history you can feel. And speaking of history we can see, check out my previous videos on the diversity of human skin colors and heights. As always, stay curious, stay smart, and thank you very much for watching.